In this video, we'll see the I/O ports available in PIC16F877 microcontroller. So basically, the use of I/O ports is to interface external peripherals to PIC microcontroller. So it is a very common peripheral. The pins which are available on PIC16F877, these I/O pins are multiplexed with some other functions as well. So we can use these pins either as a digital input output pins, or there is some other function associated with that particular pin. So at a time, we can assign only one function to that pin. So the digital I/O pins are called as ports, and it is used to control and monitor the external devices. So using these pins, we can read the data from the external device, or we can write some output to the external device. So PIC16F877 has 5 I/O ports, namely port A, port B, C, D, and E. So these are the 5 I/O ports available in PIC microcontroller. So each port is having 2 control resistors. So these resistors are having some special function. The first resistor is TRIS X. So here X indicates either A, B, C, D, or E. So it can be replaced by any of these 5 letters. So TRIS resistor is used to set the direction of that particular pin. So we can set the pin either as an input pin, or we can set it as an output pin. Then next resistor is port X, that is again port A, port B, C, D, or E. So this port resistor is used to set the output bit level. So it can be either made 1 or it can be made 0. So the status is directly affected on the external port pin of PIC controller. So first port is port A. So port A is a 6-bit bidirectional I/O port. Again, it can be used to interface any external peripheral. The data direction resistor for port A is TRIS A. So using TRIS A resistor, we can make the pins of port A either input pins or output pins, or combination of both input and output. So whenever we want to make any pin as input pin, we have to put 1 at that particular position in TRIS A resistor. So 1 makes the pin as input pin, and 0 makes the pin as output pin. All the write operations are read, modify, write operations. So first of all, the value from the resistor is read, then that value is modified, and finally the value is written to the same resistor. So that is the meaning of read, modify, and write operations. Then the pins of port A are multiplexed with the analog input pins of ADC module. So the PIC controller is also having a ADC module inside it. So the pins or the input channels of that ADC are multiplexed with port A pins. So either we can use the port A pins as digital input output pins, or we can use those pins as a ADC input pins. This is a block diagram for an individual pin of port A. So as you can see here, there are different latches. So this is a data latch and this is a TRIS latch. So data latch is used for setting the output level of the pin. It can be made either 0 or 1. Then TRIS latch is used to set the direction of the pin. So we can make the pin as input pin or output pin. So this is another D latch. Then we have some tri-state buffers and tri-state inverters. Then we have P and N MOS. So this is the actual pin. So this additional circuit is required for the alternate functions. So here port A is having, or port A can be used as a ADC input pin. So for that, this additional circuit is required, and this part of the circuit is required for digital input output pin. So the SFRs that are associated with port A are the port A resistor, then TRIS A resistor, and ADCON 1 resistor. So this ADCON is associated with port A because the pins of port A are multiplexed with ADC pins. So port A is again of 6 bits. So the lower 6 bits, that is bit 0 to bit 5, are the port bits. So if I want to make any bit either 1 or 0, I can modify that particular bit in port A resistor. So that particular pin will be made either 1 or 0. Then TRIS A is used for setting the direction. So if I want to make any particular pin of port A as input or output pin, then I have to put 1 or 0 at that particular bit position in TRIS A register. And ADCON 1 is used for making some of the pins as input pins of ADC, or we can make those pins as digital input output pins, or we can have combination of both. The next port is port B. So port B is again a 8-bit wide bidirectional IO port. So the data direction register is TRIS B. So data direction is used for setting the direction of the individual pins of port B. So if one is sent at a particular bit position, then that pin will become input pin, and if 0 is sent, then that pin will become as output pin. So each pin has a weak internal pull up in case of port B. So special control bit is provided to turn on or turn off this pull up resistors. Then RB0 slash INT is an external interrupt pin which is available on port B. So the LSB pin of port B, that is RB0, is multiplexed with the external interrupt pin, that is INT pin. So this pin can be either used as a digital input output pin, or this pin can be used as an interrupt pin. That can be configured with the help of INT EDG bit, which is present in the option resistor. Then RB7 to RB4 have interrupt on change feature. So whenever any bit on pins RB4 to RB7 make change in the status, at that time an interrupt can be generated. So such type of facility can be used for interfacing the keyboards to PIC controller. Then next is the block diagram of RB3 to RB0 pins, that is the lower four bits of port B resistor. So here, as you can see, there are again the data latch and TRIS latch available in port B as well. The difference is, again here we have a weak internal pull up available for port B. So whenever this transistor is on, at that time the pins will have a weak internal pull up, and whenever this transistor is off, at that time this pins will not be having internal pull up. So this pull up can be controlled with the help of a bit called as RBPU bar, which is present again in option resistor. Then according to the additional functions which are available for every port pin, the circuit of every port pin slightly changes. So this is the higher order bit, or higher 4 bits of port B resistor. Here again we have two latches, data latch and TRIS latch. So these data latch and TRIS latch are common for all the IO pins that are available in PIC controller. Then the additional thing is required based on what type of function, additional function or alternate function that particular pin has. So these four pins, that is RB4 to RB7 pins, have a special feature of interrupt on change. So any pin from RB4 to RB7, if the status of that pin changes, then an interrupt can be generated. So for that purpose we have a additional circuit over here which does the interrupt. Then the SFRs that are associated with port B are port B, TRIS B and option resistor. So port B is again used to set the bit level of the pin, either 1 or 0. Then TRIS B is used for setting the direction of port B pins. And option resistor is again used for here two purposes. One is that to set the internal pull up, either on or off, that is done with the help of this RBPU bar bit. And the RB0 bit of port B is multiplexed with external interrupt pin. So the edge on that pin can be configured with the help of INT EDG pin. The next port is port C. The block diagram of all the ports are almost similar, but according to the additional function that is available on that pin, there is a slight change in the block diagram. So the next port is port C, which is again having different alternate functions. So it can be used as a digital input output port, which is having a 8-bit bidirectional port, and along with that it can be used for various other functions like timer input, then timer oscillator clock input, then we have a capture compare PWM output, or CCP1, that is capture compare PWM module 1. then we can have I2C or SPI on the port C pins. For that we have the data in and data out, then we have transmit, then clock, receive and so on. So these are the alternate functions available on port C. So the SFRs that are associated with port C are port C and TRIS C. So using port C, again we can make any pin either 1 or 0, and TRIS C can be used for setting the direction of the pins of port C, either input or output. Then we have port D. So port D is having again multiplexed functions with a parallel slave port. So port D can be either used as a simple digital input output port, or it can be used as a parallel slave port. If you want to connect any parallel device to PIC 16F877, that can be connected with the help of port D. So the SFRs that are associated with port D are port D, TRIS D and TRIS E. So here TRIS E is associated because the alternate function of port E is the parallel slave port, and for controlling the parallel slave port we have some bits present in TRIS E register, so that's why TRIS E is associated with port D. The next and final port is port E. So port E is again of 3 bits, that is RE0, RE1 and RE2. Here the RE port can be used for again interfacing external peripherals. It can be used as a simple digital input output port, or it is having additional functions. Like the one function is that it is multiplexed with analog to digital converter pins, that is AN5, AN6 and AN7, whereas it can also have another function as read bar, write bar and chip select. So these read bar, write bar and chip select are again associated with the parallel slave port. So the SFRs that are associated with port E are port E, TRIS E and ADCON 1. So port E is used for making any pin of port E either 1 or 0. Only 3 bits are there. Then TRIS E is having multiple bits again. So out of that, the lower 3 bits are used for setting the direction of the bits either input or output. And ADCON is associated with port E because all the 3 pins of port E are having ADC input channels. So we can make use of these pins for giving the analog signal as an input to the A2D module present in PIC controller. And that can be configured with the help of the ADCON 1 resistor. So this is about the I/O ports available in PIC controller. In the next video, we'll see the interrupt structure available in PIC 16F877 microcontroller. For more information, you can log on to the website given in the description of this video. Thank you.